Hello, distinguished young women of Florida. My name is Chris Judd, and I wanted to wish you all good luck in the program tonight. I know that you all are having a great time there in my hometown, checking out all the sites and learning more about our community. I'm sorry that I can't be there to watch you all perform, but know that I am there rooting for each and every one of you, and I know that you will make the state of Florida proud. You all have two of the best directors in the state program, Carol Bird and Betsy Bird, whom I've known for years, and I'm sure that they've made your stay an enjoyable one and a time that you will always remember for the rest of your lives. Again, congratulations to all of you for making it to the state program, and I wish you all the best as you move on into your college years.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome your host and master of ceremonies for this evening, Mr. Ted Corcoran.
Thank you, everyone, and welcome to Fort Walton Beach, Florida, where you're honored to be the host of the Distinguished Young Women Florida State Finals 2019. That was our neighbor and Hollywood star, Chris Judd, kind of getting things started here today. We're honored to have folks here, not only from Okaloosa County, but actually all around Florida. There's folks from Pensacola, right? Milton, Osceola County, Perdido Bay, West Pay, South Jay, Jacksonville, Duval County, Washington County, Walton County, East Pace, Bayou Grande, Holmes County, and Cantonment. So we have folks from all around the state, and I just want to say on behalf of the city of Fort Walton Beach, we're honored that you're here today. It is going to be very exciting. We had the pleasure of hosting this last year, and I've had the pleasure of being an MC for this for the last couple of years. We've hosted the Okaloosa County one here, and it is absolutely amazingly enjoyable. So if it's your first time, strap yourself in, because we're going to have a really fun time. The judges are out there kind of getting ready. They're focusing themselves. I can sense it now. They're just getting gripped and ready. And we are now, speaking of ready, do we have our guests? We do. So I want to introduce, just to show how important it is, we have two very special guests who we're going to introduce to you to continue the welcome. And I want to start off with the mayor of Fort Walton Beach, the one and only Mayor Dick Rainierson.
Thank you, Ted. On behalf of the city of Fort Walton Beach, I do want to welcome each and every one of you here tonight. I had the privilege on Tuesday of welcoming the girls when they came to town. We had a dinner session at the Gulf, which is out on the island. These are fabulous young ladies. I gave each of them a key to the city, and I hope they use it often and come back and see us, especially when the sun shines here. We were a little short on sunshine this week, but other than that, I hope they had a really great week. While we were at the Gulf, it was interesting. Behind the bar in the dining room was a big neon sign said, "In Pursuit of Magic." And I thought, how fitting for those young ladies to be here in Pursuit of Magic this whole week. And I know it's all about developing life skills, and it's all about, you know, moving forward from here and the bright futures they have and going on to bigger and better things. But in my mind, it was In Pursuit of Magic. And I hope the magic begins tonight and remains with us throughout the night and a long time into the future. Again, welcome everyone. Thank you very much. And now back to our MC, Mr. Corcoran.
Thank you, Mayor Rainierson. Well done. You know, I don't have a key to the city yet, Mayor. I'll work on that. Hopefully I'll have it for you next year. Folks, we are even more honored. This is a special guest that has just come in. I did not know who was coming today, but we are very, very honored. We have our former state Senate president, the one and only Senator Don Gates, to greet us. Senator Gates.
I'm here tonight in place of a taller, smarter, better looking, much younger Gates named Congressman Matt Gates, who was invited and wanted to be here, but unfortunately he had a prior commitment in Orlando that he just couldn't break. But from time to time, because I'm his dad, I get to substitute for him. A recent substitution that he asked me to make was at the Possum Festival. And some of you who are here know what the Possum Festival is, right? For those of you who don't, if you are a guest at the Possum Festival, like I was in place of my son, you get to reach into a bag and pull out a live possum that's screaming and trying to bite you. Then you hold up the possum, then you get the privilege of buying it, and then later you eat possum. I want you to know that tonight's gig is a lot better. But I still occasionally like barbecued possum. I really also appreciate the chance to be here tonight to welcome you to Northwest Florida and to Fort Walton Beach, and on behalf of Congressman Gates, because it gives me a chance to look into the future. As I've had a chance to meet some of the young ladies who you will meet tonight, some of them you know very well because you're here to support them, just imagine their future. We've got a future environmental scientist, probably. Maybe a future great educator like Johnny Rogers from Santa Rosa County, who's here tonight to cheer for his granddaughter. You may have a future starter, founder, owner of a business that employs people and gives other people a chance to earn a living and support their families. You may very well have the next head of a family somewhere doing great things, inspiring children. Maybe you'll even have a future congressman in this group. But I would tell you this, for sure what you'll have are leaders. As I look into the future, and as you do when you meet these young ladies, you see the future of leadership. And leadership means listening, it means respect, it means courage. The courage to stand up and say what you mean. It means the presence to come before a group of people and present yourself as these young ladies are doing tonight. It means the ability to inspire, as these young ladies have in their schools and in their churches and in their communities. So tonight, you not only will meet a group of young ladies who have remarkable accomplishments so far in their lives, but imagine the kinds of people that they will be and the contributions that they'll make in their lives. And know for sure that whether it is in science or in education, whether it's in business, whether it's in family life, whether it's even in politics and in government, they will be leaders. And how lucky we are, how fortunate we are, that these young ladies will lead us into the future. Thank you.
Now you know why he was president of the state Senate. Well done, Senator Gates. Very, very nicely done. And he has set the stage, folks. If you've never been to one of these before, it is absolutely spectacular. We're going to have dancing and singing, and we're going to have all sorts of activities and such. I just want to give you kind of a housekeeping tips for safety purposes. We have exit doors over here on either side of the stage. We have exits out the back door. The restrooms are actually outside. This is an old building, so they're outside and to the left. And certainly I don't need to share that with anyone about don't take cell phone calls during the function. I think you all know that by now. So we're ready. Is everyone ready to begin the show here? It's wonderful. We are? Fabulous. I'm going to ask what we have protocol. I'll ask you to all rise. And I want you to join the one and only Olivia Clift, who is here to lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance. Olivia is certainly to be a future distinguished woman herself.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Well done, Olivia. Please be seated and get ready. Bob Levinson, are you ready? Our systems and sound guy is ready, folks. Here we go. Let's introduce the state. Distinguished Young Woman, Class of Florida 2019.
My name is Zoe Schaefer. I'm contestant number one, Distinguished Young Lady of Washington County.
Hello, my name is Michaela Gray, contestant number two, distinguished young woman of Walton County.
Good evening, I'm Ivy Berry, contestant number four, and I'm the distinguished young woman of East Pace.
Hello, my name is Jasmine Corals. I am number four, and I am the distinguished young woman of Bayou Grand.
Good evening, I'm Emily Hewitt, contestant number five, distinguished young woman of Holmes County.
I'm Jordana Jernigan, the distinguished young woman of Cantonment, contestant number six.
Trochet, and I'm contestant number seven, and I'm the distinguished young woman of West Pensacola.
Good evening, my name is Grace White, contestant number eight, and I am the distinguished young woman of Milton.
Everybody, I'm Cassie James, and I'm the distinguished young woman of Osceola County, number nine.
Hello, I'm Jasmine Soper, number 10, distinguished young woman of North Pensacola.
I'm Hannah Grace Smith, contestant number 11, distinguished young woman of Perdido Bay.
I'm Hannah Rogers, contestant number 12, and distinguished young woman of West Pace.
I'm Macy Holt, number 13, distinguished young woman of South J.
My name is Amber Barnhart, the distinguished young woman of Jacksonville, number 14.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brookie Brown, contestant number 15, your distinguished young woman from Duval County.
Hello, my name is Katie Lightfoot, and I'm contestant number 16. I'm honored to be the distinguished young woman of right here in Okaloosa County.
Distinguished young woman of Florida.
Yeah. Hold on, Valerie, don't leave. You look so fabulous.
Thank you.
We won, I remember last year. Look at this, we have a microphone for you here. It's funny, yesterday during our rehearsal, Bob Levinson, our systems and sound guy who's in the back with his good friend Brandon, we asked him to decorate the mic stand, remember? So he did a little Steven Tyler thing for us here, which is very fancy.
That is so sweet, Mr. Bob. I love it.
But we're honored. I remember last year you won. It was fantastic. Now you're on the cover of the program.
It feels so fancy.
I know. Tell us. So let's get a feel for things. What have you been doing in the last year? Give us a couple of the highlights.
So I've been at Stanford University with my freshman year of college.
Nice.
I've been performing in theater shows. I've been studying, starting a startup, and I'm just really excited to get studying and be out in college.
Wow, excited about studying. That's the spirit. That's why you won last year. That's why I didn't win. Well done. So let's talk about, you know, I'm a big autograph guy. How many autographs do you think you've signed in the last year? Because have you signed any programs today?
Not today.
Oh my gosh, ladies and gentlemen, you need to get Valerie to sign it when she becomes, when she wins a Nobel Prize or becomes a congressman. You'll say, I remember that day back in February of 2019 where I had her sign my program. But what, give just while they're getting ready in the back, what are they thinking? Give them one or two things that you think our distinguished young women are in the back are thinking and what they should be expecting the rest of the night.
I remember last year I was super nervous, so I guess in terms of what to expect, it's definitely going to be a nerve-wracking night for them, but the best advice that I can give them is to just be themselves and to remember why they're here, and that's to represent their communities and the people who have invested in them, which is all of you guys. And so when you remember that, all you can do is your best.
Well done. Well, that's like a Hallmark saying there. I'm very proud of you. And remember, that means cheering for your folks. We do allow cheering at all times. Does that help motivate you?
Absolutely. Cheering is the best.
Fantastic. Yes. Good, good. So we're going to hear from Valerie. She's coming back a couple of times. We got some surprises with Valerie coming back, but it's great to have you. Let's go back and go in the back and motivate those folks. And thank you there. So there we are, folks. There's our 2018 Distinguished Young Women. In just a couple of hours, or whatever the time frame may be, we're going to have our Distinguished Young Women State Finalists of 2019. And I want to share now, these events cannot happen without sponsors and all sorts of helpers. And I just want to go throughout the course of the night, I'm just going to be recognizing various folks. And I want to recognize, we heard already of sorts from Senator Gates regarding Congressman Matt Gates, but with Matt's audience is Sarah LaFevers and Sarah the intern. I didn't get Sarah's last name, so they're right down there, representing Matt Gates also. Standing and applauding, well done. We have sponsors. Sponsors are those folks who invest their funds to identify and make sure this is a very successful event. I saw Nick Zimmerman out there from the Jay Odom Group. Nick's right down there. Thank you, Nick. Scott, does that, you brought a little child with you, a future Distinguished Young Woman, which we're excited about. So the Jay Odom Group right there on the cover. We appreciate them. Systems of Sound, I'll be calling Bob Levinson and Brandon in the back. Systems of Sound, Bob has been doing this for 5 or 6 years now. Does it on his own?
Actually, it's a week. We stayed in the Holiday Inn Express last week.
Very good. Okay, then. Well, very nice. Well done. So Bob Hill kind of is a co-producer of this and helps out and does the lighting and such, and Brandon helping out, so we appreciate that, Bob. Heather Rees is there. Heather is down somewhere. We had Olivia. There she is, Heather from Destin Commons. While you're in town, if you need some shopping, Destin Commons, which is a wonderful place there. Eglin Federal Credit Union, Jerry Williams and Mark Franks are here. Eglin Federal Credit Union, if you need some money while you're in town, stop by and see them. Thank you very much, gentlemen there. And Gulf Power helped out. Is anyone from Gulf Power? I don't know if I saw anybody. I don't know, but I did see Denise Kendust is here from Fort Walton Beach Medical Center. Hopefully you won't need to see them while you're here, but if you do need to see them, you'll know that they are the top-rated facility in all of the state of Florida for many medical terms and such, medical illnesses, right, Denise? So hopefully you'll never have to go there. We're honored to have them here. So that's Fort Walton Beach Medical Center. And, you guys served as practice interview judges, didn't you? So some of our sponsors, as part of their, besides their financial commitment, also served as practice interview judges for the contestants, and then you'll hear later on that they actually did interview with our judges earlier today, so it's been a busy time. Now it is time to introduce the judges. I see them out there very poised and ready. And what I'd like you to do is go along with me. I want you to take out your program, because I'm gonna read along. These folks are fabulous. You're gonna get your distinguished program. Remember, have Valerie sign it later. And I want you to turn to page 30, because this is what I want you to meet our judges. Several of them have been here before. They come back every year, which is fabulous. They travel around the country and do this. So I'm going to start off in the order that's listed here. I want you to meet our judges, because I want you to know how important their role is with us today. Donna French began working with local Distinguished Young Women's Program in North Carolina in 1980. Since that time, she's worked with every phase of the program on both the local and the Georgia State program, including working with the contestants, judges, and production. She has judged numerous state programs throughout the United States. Donna is enjoying being a member of the national support team. Donna and her husband, Rick, who's coming up? Get ready for hear about Rick here, were selected as inaugural inductees into the Distinguished Young Women of Georgia Hall of Fame in 2012. That's how much they've been helping out. She is now co-chairman of the Georgia Distinguished Young Women Judges Committee. Donna has a master's degree in curriculum and instruction from North Carolina State University and also earned a degree in interior design. Being on the advisory board of Celebrity Cruise Lines has been an exciting addition to Donna's extracurricular activities. And she also has discount coupons with her today if you're thinking about going on a cruise. See Donna at the conclusion of this. I think she can get you on the March 17th out of New Orleans. The proud mom of 3 sons and 3 grandchildren, Donna lives in Woodstock, Georgia with her husband Rick, and we are honored to have back with us again Donna French, our first judge. Thank you, Donna. The lighting is kind of bright here, but I can see the shiny, shimmery outfit. You look fabulous. You wear that on cruises, don't you? I know you do, because you look wonderful. So we're honored to have Donna as our first judge. And as I mentioned, right next to her, Dr. Rick French has been actively involved with the Distinguished Young Women Junior Miss Program for the past 43 years. He started as a kindergartner and has been on it ever since. He has judged numerous local and state programs throughout the United States. After moving from North Carolina to Georgia in 1984, Rick and his wife Donna were responsible for resurrecting 2 local programs and each won national awards. Rick serves on the executive board for the Distinguished Young Women of Georgia program as judge's chairman. He is also a member of the National Distinguished Young Women Support Team and visits various state programs assisting the state committee. Rick and his wife, Donna, as we know, were inducted into the Distinguished Young Women of Georgia Hall of Fame in 2012. In his spare time, Rick enjoys singing lead for the Marietta Big Chicken Barbershop Chorus, which I would love to hear you sing during a break of that. That would be fun. Driving for Uber and spoiling his three grandchildren. He attended. Do you sing in the car while you're driving people around? That'd be really cool. Turn the radio off. I'm singing some barbershop. Where do you want to go? He attended North Carolina State University and received degrees in agriculture and vocational education. Rick and Donna reside in Woodstock, Georgia. Our second judge, the one and only Dr. Rick French. Thank you, Rick. That's fantastic. Wendy Lipham resides in Mobile, Alabama, and worked her way through college at the Mobile School of Performing Arts, where she broadened her experience in theater, music, and as a dance instructor. After 25 years as a recreational therapist and medical marker, she now works exclusively as an interview consultant. Since 1999, she has trained over 1,600 young people in the art of effective interview, including Distinguished Young Women contestants on the local, state, and national levels. She has judged numerous Distinguished Young Women programs and other interview-based competitions and has served on numerous advisory boards, including the Mobile Chamber of Commerce Advisory Board. Well done being a chamber guy. Well done, Wendy. Mobile Singing Children Board of Directors and Mobile's Gymnastics Board of Directors. She and her husband have served as host parents of National Distinguished Young Women participants and have four daughters and five beautiful grandchildren. Our third judge from Mobile, Wendy Lipham. Wendy. Thank you, Wendy. Well done. Michael Moser lives in Ticonderoga, New York, with his wife Pamela. He is the director of facility services at Middlebury College, a small liberal arts college in beautiful Middlebury, Vermont. Michael holds Bachelor of Science degrees in electrical engineering and music recording and production. He is an avid hiker of the Adirondack Mountains, enjoys playing piano and guitar, and actively supports the Boy Scouts of America. Our fourth judge, Michael Moser. Michael, thank you. And Pam Moser has been involved with local Distinguished Young Women programs in upstate New York for the past 28 years. She has held positions as chairperson, judges coordinator, and choreographer. In 2013, she obtained the role of state chairperson for New York and has made amazing friendships with volunteers around the country. Pam is the owner of Moser Drafting and Design and is a certified cheer judge for the state of New York. She currently coaches a young performance recreation cheer team, is a board member of the town of Ticonderoga Youth Commission, and is very active with the local Elks Lodge, BPOE number 1494. Our last and final judge, the one and only Pam Moser. Pam, thank you. There we have it. And we are honored for you folks to travel around the country to get here to help us out with this big event here in the state of Florida. So congratulations, judges. Helping the judges out, if you want, we have a judge's chairman. Judge's chairman is Kelly Whitfield. Kelly lives right here in Fort Walton Beach. She is a mother of three children and the wife of Mike Whitfield, who's one, I saw Mike earlier, who's one of our Distinguished Young Women van drivers this week. Mike hauling the folks around all week. We appreciate that, Mike. Kelly is a former Miss Alabama USA. This is her second year as state judge's chairman for Distinguished Young Women of Florida. She says she enjoys the position because she can help maintain the integrity of the program. Somewhere out there is Kelly Whitfield. Kelly, where are you? There she is right there. Well done, Kelly. Thank you again, Mike, for driving. That was fantastic. And then we have national travel support. We have Al and Loretta Smith, who help out with that, with the national travel support. Al and Loretta Smith, thank you for that. And we have auditors way in the back, Mac Herndon and Rochelle Waltz, who do this every single year. Where are you guys in the back? I can't see you. Where are you? Are you actually here? They're there. They're there. Okay, there they are. Yeah, thank you. There we go. Oh, there you're over there. They come every year. You look great. You're back over there in the special seats. So we're very grateful for that. And there's some great pictures of those folks in the program. And I want to thank our friends from Mobile who are also here, Lauren Barkin, Pam Bailey, Mr. Cisco Codina, and Penny Smith, who have come over from Mobile to take a gander at today's event. So those are some of our helpers that are there, and hopefully you have a chance to maybe say hello to them during the break. But there's a couple of you who are new to the Distinguished Young Women program, and I want to read a little bit about what the program has been doing. Began in 1958, the Distinguished Young Women has impacted the lives of over 765,000 young women. Our mission is to empower those young women by providing scholarship opportunities developing self-confidence, and teaching crucial life skills needed for success in college and beyond. National sponsors include Mobile County, City of Mobile, Alabama Power Foundation, Wenzel's Oyster House, Master Boat Builders, Barbara Barrington Jones Family Foundation, Evanick, Regions Financial Corporation, Jostein's, and Alabama Media Group. I'm honored to say that our winner here tonight will be attending the 62nd National Finals, which will take place in Mobile, Alabama on June 27, 28, 29. If you haven't been to that, you should certainly make note of it now, June 27, 28, 29. And the Distinguished Young Women of Florida selected tonight will be there to represent Florida, as I mentioned. For more information about Distinguished Young Women, contact the National Headquarters Marketing Communications in Mobile at distinguishedyw.org. So, wow, those thanks everyone. I know now that our folks, they've had a chance to change, and they are ready. So here we have the first segment today, Fitness Group 1.
Six. Do it like this.
Get up. Woo. Right now. Get up. Woo. Right now. Get up. Woo. Right now. Get up.
Do it like this.
Get up. Woo. Right now. Get up. Woo. Right now. Get up. Woo. Right now. Get up.
Do it like this.
Woo. Hey. Woo. Here we go. Come on. Woo. They can see us coming from a mile away. They want to see us, want to be us now. Get fancy, as you can see, we got a groove making you move. Now come on, get on your feet.
It's like 1, 2, what's the move? I got 2, 3, follow me. I got 4, 5, that's the vibe. I like 6, do it like this.
Get up, woo, right now. Get up, woo, right now. Get up, woo, right now. Get up,
do it like this.
Get up, woo, right now. Get up, woo, right now. Get up, woo, right now. Get up,
do it like this.
Number 1, Zoe Schaefer. Contestant number two, Michaela Gray.
Do it like this. Do it like this.
Contestant number three, Ivy Berry. Contestant number four, Jasmine Quarles.
Do it like this. Do it like this.
Contestant number five, Emily Hewitt. Contestant number six, Jordana Jernigan.
Do it like this.
Contestant number seven, Hilda Trochet. Contestant number eight, Grace White. All right then, folks. Well, there's our first competition. That was Fitness Group One. And if you're wondering how the judges are grading or what the percentage is, I want to note that 50% of each young woman's score has already been established. 25% of their score goes to their scholastic rankings, which includes GPA and test scores and academic involvement. That one's been taken care of. This was judged by an educator who lives outside this area about a month ago. And the results were declared at that time. Then today, each participant had a 10-minute interview with the judges' panel, which accounts for another 25% of the score. And just so you know, the young questions, yeah, we had some of the questions that they were asked. They were not like questions such as, if you were a kitchen appliance, what would it be? It was questions like, of our current U.S. Supreme Court justices, which one do you most identify with and why? So they had some serious questions that the judges created for them. So tonight, we have three categories. We have fitness, which is 15%. We have self-expression, which is 15%. And we have talent, which is 20%. And we'll see all three of those sections in different groups. And now we're going to start off with talent number two, and it looks like they're ready. But before they start, I do want to advise you that I'll be reading descriptions from the people. They've created them themselves. They wrote them and supplied them to me. So I will be reading exactly what they've written. So in this case here, it is talent group two. Starting off, Cassandra James has a passion for storytelling and the power of words. Influenced by country, jazz, and blues artists, she began writing her own music when she was very young. She writes songs that she hopes move, change, and inspire people. She has performed around Central Florida and plans to continue writing and performing in the future. She has wrote and produced this song to show a friend who had lost her way about the power of loving every part of who you are. Number nine, Cassandra James.
In a room made of glass, there's a girl in a corner trying to look like a crowd.
Her face drowns in fake curls and lashes, and her lipstick makes her mouth look loud. She likes what you do till you don't, and she doesn't dig a grave for every tea. When I tell her how I miss her, there's nothing in her eyes but fear. Could you tell the girl I knew? Tell her that she's beautiful and tell her that she's loved. Tell her nothing nobody says could ever change her heart. Tell her that she doesn't have to be lonely. Could you tell her that for me? Tell her she's a princess and tell her she's not worthless. Tell her she can chase and walk the road she's dreaming of. It didn't have to go this way. We started out, we were the same, but you went your way and I went mine. Tell her she can drop the mask, that's all I ask. Would you tell her that for me?
Number 9, Cassandra James, the Distinguished Young Women of Osceola County. Well done. Well done. And these gentlemen, our distinguished young gentlemen, will be kind of our deckhands here, bringing microphones in and out in a very professional way, no doubt. We hope, certainly so. All right then. Next we have Jasmine Soper. She's a senior at West Florida High School. Jasmine has been dancing for 14 years at Five Flags Dance Academy. She's a member of Five Flags Dance Academy's senior competition team and ballet company. She and her team have been awarded multiple awards, including many first overalls. Today she'll be performing a jazz dance to I Wanna Dance With Somebody, number 10, Jasmine Soper. Distinguished Young Women of North Pensacola, Florida. Ooh, it is getting fun in here already. Well done. Music and theater have been a part of Hannah Grace Smith's life since the day she was born. Growing up in an art-centered home exposed her to many kinds of music and entertainment, but there was one form that she was specifically drawn to, musical theater. One of Hannah Grace's favorite shows is the 25th annual Putnam County Spelling Bee. Tonight she'll be performing a song from the show in which child prodigy Marcy Park explains her many achievements, including fluency in 6 languages. Here we have number 11, Hannah Grace Smith.
I speak 6 languages. Every language easy. Easy as the recipe for making jello. I speak 6 languages, and I can say hello in at least 7 more. To excel in athletics is not difficult if one has the temperament. Apparently, I have the temperament. Yes, I score some goals, so unfazed am I as my life unscrolls.
Meets in Stephen Mayer. I speak six languages. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Number 11, Hannah Grace Smith, the singer-songwoman of Perdido Bay, Florida. And this is really fun. I enjoy this. Hannah Rogers has been dancing since the age of 2. Throughout those 15 years, she has competed and won awards at several dance competitions all across the South. She has danced with the Disney Performing Arts Program and participated at multiple dance conventions. Tonight, she'll be performing to The Way You Make Me Feel by Michael Jackson, choreographed by Mallory Cole. Number 12, Hannah Rogers. Sounds great. I thought it would never be gone. I thought someone was actually clapping at the beginning of that. That was fantastic. Man, it was good. Macy has been a part of the drama program at her school since first grade. Since first year. She loves to do makeup for school's plays and helping run mics and set. This will be her second year as drama club secretary. Macy created an original pantomime this year to take to her district drama competition where she received an excellent on her piece. She's excited to see what this year in drama has in store for her. Today she'll be performing Silence by Diathon Macy Holt, number 13.
Crazy? Do you think I'm crazy, doctor? I know what that paper says and I know what it means, but do you? Have you ever met my girls a day in your life? No, you haven't. How could you possibly know what I'm going through? How could you know how much it hurts to lose someone so close to you? You don't. I had everything anyone could have ever wanted. I had a loving husband, 3 beautiful children, and a wonderful home. And then came the fire. I put the girls down for our afternoon nap, and I never fall asleep. But this time I did. I woke up to my oldest daughter screaming, Mom! Mom, the house is on fire! I ran to go get the twins upstairs, and on my way up, the stairs collapsed, breaking my arm. I tried as hard as I could to get to them. I couldn't. They were screaming, Mommy, Mommy, please help me, and I couldn't get to them. I thought that was the worst thing I've ever heard, but that was really music to my ears when the next thing I heard was silence. I begged and pleaded for them to call for me just one more time. They never did.
Right then. Number 13, Macy Hall, the singer's young women of South Jay, Florida. Congressman Gates was just in Jay, Florida, wasn't he? Just 2 days ago, visiting the folks over there. Oh my gosh, this is great. Amber Barnhart has danced 10 years under the instruction of Scott Jones and is enrolled at Douglas Anderson School of the Arts, where she builds her technique in ballet, traditional, modern, and contemporary dance. Her dance exemplifies her ability to perform and the skills she has worked on over the years. Number 14, Amber Barnhart.
Yeah. life is so simple. A little boy, a little girl, laughing and loving, trying to figure out the world. Family dinners and family trees, teaching the kids to say thank you and please, knowing if we stay together that things will be right.
Distinguished young woman of Jacksonville. Man, all right then. Brookie Brown represents Duval County, where she has performed the national anthem at charity events such as Canine for Warriors, puppy graduations, and the 6,000 plus crowd at Iceman hockey games. Tonight, Brookie will sing O Mio Babbino Caro in Italian from the Puccini opera. Here it is, number 15, Brookie Brown. She's a triple threat athlete. Each sport she plays contributes to the strength and agility needed in this fast-paced hand-clapping routine. She has incorporated tumbling and dance elements into this high-energy performance. She has choreographed a spectacular routine to Footloose by Kenny Loggins. Number 16, Katie Lightfoot.
Been working so hard, I'm punching my car. Thank you.
Katie Lightfoot, Distinguished Young Woman of Okaloosa County. Whoa! And that, my friends, is the end of talents for group two. Judges, holy cow, the choices you have to make are absolutely amazing. Now, I am pleased we have a next section, which is self-expression, group one. And I am honored, folks, you are in the presence of royalty here, because helping ask the questions today is Mimi Taylor, Distinguished Young Woman of Florida from 2016, and our good friend Valerie Trapp, the Distinguished Young Woman of State from 2018. Ladies, are you ready to ask some questions? There are, right there, they are ready. Here they are, Mimi and Valerie.
Thank you.
Question is, do you think that millennials can become strong leaders?
I do believe millennials can become strong leaders. Through all the resources we have nowadays, they have many more opportunities to gain those leadership skills, and also through hard work and determination, they can become very strong leaders. Thank you. Zoe Schaefer, contestant number one.
Next, we have contestant number two, Michaela Gray. Michaela, your question is, what is your opinion of global warming?
The debate on global warming centers around the issue of whether or not humanity is furthering the Earth's natural warming process, and I believe it does. With the consistent excess of pollution put into our environment, it is hard to believe otherwise. With the unprecedented worldwide industrialization, it is much better to be safe than sorry, and we must take action now. Contestant number two, Michaela Gray.
Contestant number three, Ivy Berry. Ivy, recently multiple historical statues were removed in cities across the country. What is your opinion of that?
I believe our statues shouldn't be removed because they are a part of our history, and they're a very important part of our history. I know some people have been offended by some Confederate leaders, but I know that some mistakes made in the past need to be seen so we can make sure that they are not made in the future. Thank you. Ivy Berry, contestant number three.
Contestant number four, Jasmine Quarles. Jasmine, do you think that women's physical standards in the military need to be the same as military men's standards?
Genetically, women are not as strong as men. Therefore, women should not be held to the same standard as men. However, I do believe women do need to be held to a high standard so that they are safe in combat, defending our country. Jasmine Quarles, number four.
Next up, we have number 5, Emily Hewitt. Emily, how do you think a teenager should handle peer pressure?
I think a teenager should handle peer pressure by surrounding themselves with confident people and to always walk away and stand their ground and be the bigger person. Contestant number 5, Emily Hewitt.
Next, we have contestant number 6, Jordana Jernigan. Jordana, do you think that fewer guns would result in less gun violence?
Fewer guns would reduce our Second Amendment right to bear arms. It is the person behind the gun that is the problem. We should be putting more restrictions on who can handle guns. Jordana Jernigan, contestant number 6.
We have contestant number 7, Hilda Trochet. How do you feel about women in the military being in combat?
I think it's pretty amazing that women are fighting for our country and fighting for our rights just as equal as men. Hilda Trochet, contestant number 7.
Last but certainly not least, we have contestant number 8, Grace White. Grace, what is your opinion on a college professor's $70,000 salary versus a college football coach's $1 million or more dollar salary?
I believe that educators should be getting paid just as much, if not more, because they are the ones raising our future leaders. But it's really a question of, is the value of the money that athletic coach is bringing to the school, or is it the professor's job? Grace White, number 8.
Mimi and Valerie, I am going to ask some of those questions to random people in the audience during the break and see how well you do. Holy cow, that was fantastic. Last night during the practice, they don't ask them the original questions. I had questions like, what kind of hair curler do you use? So I had no idea the magnitude of the question. Senator Gates, those are some good topical questions, were they not? Absolutely. Man, that was wonderful. So that we have was self-expression group 1, and now it's back down to fitness group 2. Bob, hit it.
Getting fancy, as you can see, we got a groove making you move. Now come on, get on your feet. 1, 2, what's the move I got to do? 5x96. Do it like this.
Woo! Right now, get up. Woo! Right now, get up. Woo! Right now, get up.
Do it like this.
Get up. Woo! Right now, get up. Woo! Right now, get up. Woo! Right now, get up.
Do it like this.
Contestant number 9, Cassie James.
Do it like this. Do it like this.
Contestant number 10, Jasmine Soper.
Do it like this.
Contestant number 11, Hannah Grace Smith. Contestant number 12, Hannah Rogers. Contestant number 13, Macy Holt. Contestant number 14, Amber Barnhart.
Do it like this.
Changes today, I see. Welcome back. So that was Fitness Group 2. Unbelievable. Judges and everybody, that was something. Well done, Bob Levinson, Systems of Sound. The sound sounds wonderful. And now we are almost ready. I think we are ready for Talent Group 1. And once again, I'll be reading what the contestant has written on their card for the description. Zoe Schaefer has been dancing since the age of 2. She enjoys all types of dance and has competed with her dance troupe for 3 years. Zoe will be performing a lyrical dance to Skinny Love. Here's number 1, Zoe Schaefer.
Come on, Skinny Love, just last the year. So we were never here. My. Staring at the sink of blood and crushed veneer.
Strong woman of Washington County. A good start to this round here. We have a microphone. Yes, I thought we did. Look at that. You're looking very professional, by the way, in that outfit. Yesterday's here with a cut-up t-shirt and ripped jeans, but today, a professional backstage guy. Well done, well done. All right then, here we go. Michaela Gray has been playing clarinet for 9 years, and she hopes to continue playing for the rest of her life. She has been chosen for numerous honor bands and holds the first chair in her band. The opening solo from Rhapsody in Blue by George Gershwin is one of her personal favorites, for it introduced her to the world of creativity and jazz. Here she is, number 2, Michaela Gray. distinguished young woman of Walton County. That's nice. Coming along, here we have it now. Ivy Berry has been singing since third grade and has been a member of the Pensacola Children's Chorus for 7 years. She'll be singing tonight Fly, Fly Away by Catch Me If You Can. Ivy Berry, number 3.
Who they call real really fakes, who left me nothing but this man they call a fake gave me something real. I've known cruel, cruel men with Christian names who taught me manners, but this man without a name taught me how to feel.
Distinguished woman of East Pace, Florida. Jasmine puts the song Put Your Record On to life through her Color Guard performance. Color Guard is a non-musical section of the band that provides visual aspects to the performance through the synchronized work of flags, sabers, rifles, and through dance. Jasmine has been part of her Color Guard team and Tate Chaparral's for the last 4 years. Here she is, Jasmine Quarles, number 4.
Birds out of my window, and they told me I don't need to worry. Summer came last in the 90s, so sweet. Little girls double dutch on the concrete. Maybe sometimes we got it wrong, but it's alright. The more seem to change, what I stay the same. Ooh, don't you hesitate.
Oh, put your records on. Tell me your favorite song. You go ahead, let your head down. Sapphire and faded jeans. I hope you get your dream. Just go ahead, let your head down. You're gonna find yourself somewhere, somehow.
Jasmine Quarles, number 4, distinguished young woman of Bayou Grande, Florida. Given the opportunity to join dance with her preschool class, started Emily Hewitt's love for dance. She's been dancing for 12 years and has been participating in competitions since the fourth grade. She just participated in her second project, Dance, which is a movement of dancers seeking to positively impact culture through artistic integrity. Here's Emily dancing to Man in the Mirror, choreographed by Carrie Rines. Number 5, Emily Hewitt.
Gonna make a change for once in my life. It's gonna feel real good. Gonna make a difference. Gonna make it right. As I turn up the collarboard, my favorite winter coat, this wind is blowing my mind. The kids in the street, but not enough to eat. Who am I?
she is, number five, Emily Hewitt, distinguished young woman of Holmes County. Pursuing her passion for the medical field, Jordana Jernigan has decided to share with you a presentation of CPR. Her goal in this presentation is to spread awareness to all the audience so they are capable of performing CPR on others if the need arises. Jordana earned her certification at Florida State University's Summer Medical Institute, and she has used this skill at Naval Hospital Pensacola and West Florida Hospital, where she is a summer volunteer in the Progressive Care Unit. Here is number six, Jordana Jernigan.
Code blue, I see you. Code blue, I see you. Code blue, I see you. Code blue, I see you.
Hi everyone, this is my friend Manny Quinn, and he suddenly collapsed in front of me. The first thing I'm gonna do is check for a pulse and is he breathing. If I find no signs of either of those, you're going to tell someone around you to grab an AED and call 911. You take your dominant hand, place it palms down in the middle of the chest, and take your other hand and interlace the fingers. You compress about 2 to 3 inches down in the middle of the chest. You do this for 100 compressions per minute, and after 5 minutes, you're going to do 30 compressions and 2 breaths. It's completely okay if you feel the ribs cracking. That just means you're getting access to that heart and pumping the blood throughout the whole body. With that, I leave you, and I hope all of you have learned how to save a life, and I hope you have it in your heart to save a heart.
Number six, Jordana Jernigan, a singer-songwriter woman of Cantonment, Florida. Here we go. Oh, we have a new guy coming out here, I see. You've been in the back. Would you come in late or something? All right, nice to have you out here. Folks, we're gonna hear from our distinguished young gentlemen in a little bit. They're probably in the back prepping for that. That's gonna be an extra bonus fun scenario there. All right. Hilda Trochet has been a member of the Pensacola Children's Chorus for 4 consecutive years, this year being the 5th year. She has placed 2nd and won the Bill Jennings Scholarship twice at the Pensacola Music Theater's annual Sonata competition. She has participated in musical events such as the 2017 High School Summer Theater Program at Pensacola State College. Hilda plans on pursuing a career in the musical arts, either as a performer or theater director. She will now perform Nella Fantasia. Here she is, number 7, Hilda Trochet. Distinguished young woman of West Pensacola, Florida. I was just joking about you arriving late. I saw you here early. Just want to double check. I want to make sure I didn't misguide the audience here for your volunteering. Grace White started dancing when she was 3 years old and studies all genres of dance, her favorite style being lyrical. Tonight she had planned to perform a piece titled Ashes, choreographed by Miss Ashley Barnett. But as you can see, Grace recently broke her foot, however, so she will present a monologue instead. Here we have number 8, Grace White.
Time and I have always had a sort of love-hate, yin-yang kind of relationship. There have been times when I laughed and times when I cried, but time, nonetheless, has always pushed me forward towards the thing I love the most, dancing. From the age of 3 to now at 17, the studio has become my second home. Many of my conversations include, sorry I can't tonight, I have dance, or can we reschedule, that's a show day. And although it's been hectic and stressful at times, I wouldn't have it any other way. Most of my time, energy, and emotions have all been put into this art that I love so much. Time stopped for me a few weeks ago. A few weeks ago, doing this thing that I love so much, I stumbled, I fell, and I broke my foot in the process. Through all of the overwhelming emotions and heartache that come with this injury, I am learning that this is just a minor inconvenience and I will be stronger from it. And although I wish I could be dancing for you all today more than anything, I know that anything can be overcome with time. Thank you.
Number 8, Grace White, the Shingle Swung Woman of Milton, Florida. And folks, I'm amazed as you are, that is the conclusion of Talent Group 1. I enjoyed that, absolutely amazing. So now, we're gonna jump back to the self-expression for group 2, and I am pleased now to introduce your questionnaires. We have the one and only Natalie Lawson, who was Distinguished Young Woman of Florida 2014, and she was selected as a Nationals Top 10 finalist. That's Natalie right there with the basket full of cheer. And helping her out is the fantastic Caitlin Mosley, who seems to do everything here. So Caitlin, ladies, they're yours.
First up, we have contestant number 9, Miss Cassie James. Cassie, do you think that millennials can become strong leaders?
I recently started a mentorship program in my speech and debate club, pairing younger students with older students so that they can further their communication and leadership skills. And I saw through that program and through programs like DYW that anybody can be a leader if they build up their relational skills, their communication skills, and if they learn how to put themselves forward in a confident way that they can encourage and inspire others. So yes, millennials can be leaders just as anybody can if they work at it. Cassie James, number 9.
Next up, we have contestant number 10, Ms. Jasmine Soper. Now we have Ms. Jasmine. Jasmine, how do you feel about women in the military being in combat?
I believe that anyone, including women, should be allowed to be in the military and be in combat as long as they meet the qualifications. Jasmine Soper, number 10.
Next up, we have contestant number 11, Ms. Hannah Grace Smith. Hannah Grace, do you think that fewer guns would result in less gun violence?
Well, I do think that removing assault rifles from circulation would help reduce the amount of
the amount of occurrences of gun violence, I do believe that a better approach is to increase the vetting that we give gun owners and to increase background checks to ensure that guns do not go into the wrong hands. Hannah Grace Smith, contestant number 11.
Next, we have contestant number 12, Hannah Rogers. Hannah, how do you think a teenager should handle peer pressure?
I believe that a teenager should handle peer pressure through a great support system and great friends. Hannah Rogers, contestant number 12.
Next, we have number 13, Miss Macy Holt. Macy, what's your opinion of a college professor's $70,000 salary versus a college football coach's $1 million or more salary?
I personally feel that it's more important for a professor to get paid more because academics are more important. Education is forever and you build up your knowledge that way. In athletics, you necessarily don't do that. You might build up stamina and strength, but your brain doesn't get stronger that way. Macy Holt, number 13.
Next, we have contestant number 14, Miss Amber Barnhart. Amber, what is your opinion of global warming?
I think global warming is a serious issue that we don't pay enough attention to. I think we're leaving it up to future generations to deal with, and I think that we should be addressing that issue now by reducing our carbon footprint. Amber Barnhart, number 14.
Next, we have contestant number 15, Miss Brookie Brown. Recently, multiple historical statues were removed in cities across the country. What is your opinion of that?
I believe we should not be removing historical statues. They represent what we were founded on, and they represent some of the mistakes we've made. Without these statues, we do not have a visual representation on keeping our beliefs the same or getting away from the mistakes we make with that visual reminder. Brookie Brown, contestant number 15.
And last but not least, we have contestant number 16, Miss Katie Lightfoot. Katie, do you think that women's physical standards in the military need to be the same as military men's standards?
Women's physical standards in the military should be the same as men's standards. The standards tests are set up for a reason, so that when they go into combat, they're ready to be a strong defense. We live in the land of the free because of the brave, and we should have a strong defense system.
Expression group two. Judges, tell me it cannot be so. Tell me that that's all we get to see. Is that's it? Oh my gosh, I can't believe it, folks. So we've seen the talent, we've seen the fitness, we've seen the self-expression, which means Mimi Taylor is tasked now with escorting our judges, our auditors, and our judges' chairman to the special little room where they get to discuss and select a winner. So while they're doing that, we wish you the best out there, everyone. We can't wait to see you when you come back. I do want to share some observations of some people who are helping things. First is the choreographer, Lauren Hudson, who I just saw a second about. She's running around. So you have Lauren, who's a student at Northwest Florida State College, and she's assisted by Katie Shank, also a student, and they got represented in the program, which is also very cool. Very happy about that. Erica Wright, I guess, is back there, right, Ken? Is she back there? It's so dark back here, I can't see anything, but there's one light over there. They have a little flashlight. But Erica Wright is the head backstage mom. She's absolutely fantastic. We are honored, folks, that we are having our good friend Valerie Trapp, our distinguished young woman, return. So here we have Valerie Trapp, our current distinguished young woman of Florida, started taking ballet lessons when she was 6 years old. Since then, she has trained at the Orlando Ballet School for 11 years and over the summer at the Vienna State Opera Ballet in Austria. Valerie will be performing her original choreography to Ella Fitzgerald and Louis Armstrong's They Can't Take That Away From Me, our current young distinguished woman of Florida, the one and only Valerie Trapp.
The way you wear your hat, the way you sip your tea, the memory of all that. No, no, they can't take that away from me. The way your smile just beams, the way you sing off key, the way you haunt my dreams. No, no, they can't take that away from me. We may never, never meet again on the bumpy road to love. Still, I'll always, always keep the memory of the way you hold your knife, the way we dance till three, the way you've changed my life. No, no, they can't take that away from me. No, they can't take that away from me.
Well done, Valerie. Valerie, thank you for that. And of course, is our current distinguished young woman of Florida, the one and only Valerie Trapp. Now you have, folks, the distinguished young gentleman under the choreography of the one and only Lauren Hudson. Gentlemen, you're up.
Can't touch this. Can't touch this. Can't touch this. My, music hits me so hard, makes me say, oh my Lord, thank you for blessing me. When I'm mind to run it, too hype, it's just good when you know you're down. A super dope homeboy from the old town, and I'm known as such, and this is me, you can't touch it. I told you, homeboy, you can't touch this. Yeah, that's how we living, and you know, you can't touch this. Look at my eyes, man, you can't touch this. Yo, let me bust the funk lyrics. Fresh new kicks and bands. You got it like that. Now you know you want to dance. So move out of your seat and get a fire going and catch the beat.
So now I see why Valerie warmed up the backstage boys, obviously, here. I thought it'd be relevant while we're waiting. Let's introduce this. Some of these guys have been doing this for a long time. So I'm gonna pass the mic, and we're gonna start with you. I want you to introduce yourself, if you could, and tell them what grade you're in, what you're doing, and then I'll ask you some very topical question that I will make up in about 10 seconds. So here we go.
All right. I am Mason Bruns. I am a senior at the Choctahatchee High School.
There you go. So you have, hold on a second before I want to ask each of you a question, then we'll go down from there.
Okay.
So you now have been doing this for the 5 years you've been doing it, right? Your brother started it.
He did,
and you've kind of kept on. So what is the best part of being one of the cool backstage distinguished young gentlemen, since you've been doing it so long?
Getting all the girls' numbers.
Kind of all right, that. Okay. Can we say that? Are we able to, I guess so, all right.
No, In all honesty, it's really about serving others. It's a great community service opportunity. It looks good on the resume. It's really fun. I like to work with these guys and love this Betsy, Miss Carol, and everyone who helps. And
there we go. But of course, the first answer was really your real answer, and then one was canned after that. So, yeah. Next up, our friend, he has been doing this for a while too. I know he's in college now. What are you?
My name is Brayden Bennis, and I am going to Florida State University. So
there we go. So what are you going to say when you go back to college? Are you just home for the weekend?
Yes, sir.
Just home for the weekend. So when you go back to see your friends, et cetera, back at FSU over there in Tallahassee, what are you going to tell them you did this weekend?
Tell them I busted a move a little bit.
Nice. And you know, we've recorded it. It's recorded. It's all around the world up here. R.J. Murdoch is recording this here, which is going to be great. So everyone around the world, there's people in Hawaii that just saw that, which is really cool. Next up, this guy's been doing this for a while, too. Nice to see you. Introduce yourself, if you could, sir.
My name is Campbell Taylor. I'm a senior in Iceville High School.
There we go. The Eagles. And now, this is how many years have you been doing this?
I think this is my fourth.
All right, then. And how would you document this on a resume if you were, you know, for your college exposition? How do you describe this service to your community?
Probably title it Distinguished Young Women Scholarship Opportunity.
You played football at Northfield, didn't you?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I thought so. Is this as hard as it hard for you to do this here today, carrying the stuff out there and seeing the women dance?
Definitely not.
Okay, just checking on that. And we got a new guy that came ahead. I just met him yesterday. Tell us about yourself, my friend.
My name is Colton Hammond. I'm a junior at Niceville High School.
There we go. Look at that. So first time, you got some veterans here. How did they coerce you to do this? What was it that said, yeah, I'm going to volunteer and go for the next week of volunteering?
Well,
what did they really say? Just what did they really say?
I think they just tried to be supportive because some of them couldn't be out here every single day, so they just wanted me to be there so somebody would be there.
All right then, well, that was calm and relaxing. So we have, at the end here, we got the guys with the hair. These are the hair guys at the end. We're going to be an 80s hair band. They're coming back. You have been here before, my friend. Tell us your name and what grade you're in.
My name is Gray Bennis, and I'm a junior at Choctahatchee High School.
Oh, that's right. You've been doing this for a long. You were like in the sixth grade, I think, when you started, weren't you?
Yeah, eighth grade.
Eighth grade. Okay, good. And just wrap it up here. How wonderful is it to be the stagehands, hanging out with the distinguished young woman of the state of Florida?
And it just feels great to help all these young women and be able to help them with, you know, getting scholarship money and.
How many selfies have you taken?
Zero.
Next year, we need a crop of people who have some spunk in them, all right then? Gentlemen, the distinguished young gentlemen, we're very happy to have you guys here. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Well done. All right, folks, I have three announcements for you here before we go. Three announcements. We have a 15-minute intermission. If you are present here tonight and have participated in a Junior Miss or Distinguished Young Woman program in any year at any level, please look for Caitlin Mosley on the way out, because after we come back from intermission, we're going to have a little thing where you get to introduce yourself, which is cool. Two, after this event, everyone is invited to a brief reception immediately following the program. It's at the Island Resort. The Island Resort, this is Highway 98, which is right out front here. You would go east on Highway 98. You'd go over the Brooks Bridge, the first bridge you encounter, and the island is up there on the right-hand side. It's about probably 5 miles from here on the right-hand side. They're having a little party. The photographer will be there taking formal photos, group and random photos, so please, please take care of that. We don't want you coming up on the stage to take the photos after the event, so the island, that's your number two place that you're going to. And parents of any of the distinguished young women, we have your luggage and such over here. If you'd like to drive your car, which is called Stage Right, you can load up and get that ready. So after the event, you can head back to the island. So folks, let's see what time I have on my clock. I've got 8:12. We're taking a roughly 15-minute intermission. We're going to go out the door. Restrooms are to the left. There's a little snack bar, a little vending machine. All good. Have a good time. We'll see you in 15 minutes. Folks, welcome back, welcome back, welcome back. It is time to begin the proceedings, and in a very short moment, I have no doubt the judges are going to arrive. They'll have in their hands the list of the winners, and we will make the important announcements. But before we do that, I want to share one thing about the program. I was looking at the program. That's fantastic. I want to thank Erica Wright for creating that program. Take that home with you and review that. Good stuff, good souvenir of today's activities. Who is, I see the gathering of the Distinguished Young Women alumni over there. Who's gonna take the lead and come on up here and introduce themselves? Caitlin is. So let me introduce the one and only Caitlin Mosley, who will be getting things started here to introduce our distinguished young women.
So while they are coming out on stage, these are very bright lights, I can't see anybody. So my name is Caitlin Mosley. I'll further introduce myself at the end, but basically, Distinguished Young Women is all about a lifetime experience. It's not just a one-day program and then you say goodbye, as you will see by all of the amazing women that are forming the stage behind me right now. They have all participated, whether it be local, state, or national, and we are so happy and thrilled that they come back and join us on stage to kind of share a little bit about, you know, who they are and what they're doing. So I'll let them get started and we'll go from there. Ooh, those lights are bright. Hey guys, I'm Randy Avery. I was the DYW of North Escambia County. I'm currently at the University of Alabama. Roll Tide, yeah. All right, I'm studying elementary education. I'm in the Million Dollar Band. If any of y'all were here last year, I was a boogie woogie bugle trumpet girl. I'm also in the Alpha Delta Chi sorority, and I'm also a mentor with the Owls Pals Mentorship Program. So, roll tide!
Okay, hi! My name is Elizabeth Ames. I forgot my title. I was the Northwest Santa Rosa County DYW of 2018. Now I am at Florida State University, go Noles. I am also studying elementary education, which is a little different than last year. I started with finance and it just died really quickly. So now we're doing something more fun. I'm also, next year I just got hired as an RA on campus, so I'm really excited for that. I'm also in the honors program and the honors experience program, which don't ask me what that is because nobody knows because it's brand new this year. So yeah.
Good evening. My name is Taya Lane. I was the Distinguished Young Woman of Washington County for the class of 2016. Woo! I competed for state and I won the talent preliminary, and now I currently serve on the board as production and choreographer chair. So that's fun. I recently graduated from college with a degree in management and accounting. I work as an accountant for my father-in-law's business, and I just recently got married.
Hi everyone, my name is Mary Mason White and I was the first runner-up for the class of 2019 Distinguished Young Woman Program right here in Okaloosa County. And I plan to further my education at the University of Florida next year, majoring in biomedical engineering. Go Gators!
Hello, I'm Courtney Swanson. I was part of Katie's class here in Okaloosa for class of 2019. I'm currently a collegiate high school senior, and I'll be graduating in May with my AA.
Hey y'all, I'm Ariana Wittick. I participated in the class of 2019 Distinguished Young Woman of Okaloosa County. I plan on attending Florida State University in the fall to major in meteorology.
Everyone, my name is Mimi Taylor, and I am the Distinguished Young Woman of Okaloosa County and the Distinguished Young Woman of Florida for 2016.
Oh, thank you guys, whoa.
I'm a current junior at the University of Alabama studying biology and Spanish to pursue a career in the medical field as a physician assistant. So thank you all so much for being here, and roll tide.
Well, this is the last thing I expected to do when I drove here. I drove up from Sarasota because I participated in the Distinguished Young Woman program that was then known as America's Junior Miss. And I won a local program in Kentucky, and I was the second runner up in the Kentucky Junior Miss program in... This is my 50th anniversary of being a junior miss, 1969. I came to the University of Florida following that, go Gators, and I never left. And I was brought back into the program a few years ago when a young cousin participated in the program in Kentucky and won the same title that I did. So I came here to see what Florida's program is about, and I'm glad to be here. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Lynn Green. I was with the Junior Miss program, class of 1997. I am the mom of Hannah Rogers, who is one of the contestants tonight. I'm an accountant and payroll supervisor for the Santa Rosa County School District and also a realtor with Caldwell Banker. Thank you.
Well, this was the last thing I thought I would be doing tonight also. I'm Patricia Hain, and I participated in the Escambia County Junior Miss, class of 1971. And I'm here tonight because my granddaughter is one of the participants tonight, Hannah Rogers. And I'm an educator, a special education educator in Santa Rosa County, and also a pianist.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Lauren Hudson, and I was second runner-up for the Distinguished Young Women Class of 2017 for Okaloosa County. I'm currently a sophomore at Northwest Florida State College. I have a performing arts scholarship, and I'm captain of the Raider Rhythms dance team. In the fall, I plan on transferring to Florida State University to pursue my master's degree in speech-language pathology. And I'm right now I am the choreographer and production manager for the program you are here for tonight. So I'd like to thank you all for coming to support. Thank you.
Good evening. Oh, the mic's right there. Hello. My name is Katie Schenk, and I was a member of the Distinguished Young Women Class of 2017 for Okaloosa County, and I was the Arden Robertson Spirit Award winner. I am a current sophomore at Northwest Florida State College pursuing my doctorate in physical therapy, and I also have a vocal scholarship with Lauren. She's my best friend. She's amazing. And what she failed to mention is that we are actually going to France in the spring with our Performing Arts Center, and we are so excited for that. I am the assistant production manager for this amazing class here, and I'm also a roadie, do whatever they tell me, so I just love this program very much.
Hello, my name is Marcella Plogue, and I was the 2018 Distinguished Young Woman of Northeast Santa Rosa County. I competed at state here last year in 2018 and was the overall fitness winner. Now I am at the University of West Florida studying nursing.
Hi everyone, I'm Angelica Jones, and I was the DYW of Jacksonville last year, and I won the overall talent award and was first alternate to Valerie Trapp. Currently, I'm a freshman at the University of Florida, and I'm studying both political science and broadcast news. So, go Gators.
Hi again, everyone. I'm Valerie Trapp. I'm the Distinguished Young Woman of Florida for 2018, and I was the second runner-up at Nationals. And I'm studying right now at Stanford University in California, and I'm studying international relations and psychology.
Hello, everyone. My name is Olivia Waite, and I was the 2018 Distinguished Young Woman of Southeast Santa Rosa County. I'm currently studying marketing at the University of West Florida, and I will soon be starting a marketing internship with Florida West.
I can't see anyone. I'm just going to speak from the heart. My name is Gina Moss, and I would hope that everybody in this room would be sworn to secrecy, but 41 years ago, I was Jefferson County's Junior Miss, and at that time, Miss Carol will know this, there was a brand new chairman of that program, and his name was Eddie Maxud, who prepared me immensely for the opportunities that awaited me at State. That opened up this crazy world for me that, you know, I look back at it now and I see what these girls are going through, and you just, you don't know what's going on now until it actually happens to you 10 years in the future, 20 years, or in my case, 40 or 50 years. But what is really terrific and what's great about life now is my husband Charlie and I are a host family. And we have, at this point, four girls here that are competing or have won or have just excelled in so many different ways. And then two gals that are right next to me to my right back here that I'm on the board for the Walton County Distinguished Young Women Program. And I'm telling you what, things now that you think are so small, small kindnesses that these girls share backstage make immense differences in their life. And this is the most generous program, and everyone should open your pocketbook in your home to be a host family or to just contribute to this program, because it's fabulous. Thank you.
Hi everyone, I'm Julie Stuckey. I was Monroe County's Junior Miss in 2003. I was also a top eight state finalist for Alabama. Currently am on, am the chairman for Walton County's program. It's our second year, so we're happy to be here at State. A little bit more about me, I guess. I'm actually a marketing consultant. I do global communications for a company called Advito, and actually flew in today from Barcelona, so I was in here just in time for the program, so I'm very excited to be here.
My name is Sarah Schuler Hill, and I was the 2004 Junior Miss in Warden, Washington. I am serving on the Walton County Board, and like Julie said, this is our second year, and it's been a big honor to be back involved with the program. I was involved with the program since I was a little girl. My mom was the Junior Miss in my same hometown in 1984, and I have my 5-year-old daughter here with me tonight, so this is pretty fun.
Hello, my name is Natalie Lawson. I was the Distinguished Young Woman of Okaloosa County in 2014 and also the Distinguished Young Woman of Florida in 2014 as well. And I made it in the top 10 at Nationals, which was so fun. But now I have just recently graduated from Florida State University, woo, with my degree in biological science, and I plan to pursue my master's maybe somewhere in Europe, so that's fun. And I'm so excited to be back to see all these lovely girls, and go Noles.
Hey, I'm Paula Stokes, now Wilkinson. I just got married too. We've been together for 11 years, so it was time he did this. I had to have the distinguished honor of being a Junior Miss from, I refuse to say how long ago, in Geneva County, Alabama. I went to Troy State University on a Junior Miss scholarship. I went to Auburn, and I currently, thank you, War Eagle. All these Noles and Gator people, just really. I had the honor of conducting an interview workshop for these amazing young women the other day, and they were so much fun to get along with. And believe it or not, a Southern woman can communicate. I forgot what I was going to tell y'all. Natalie and I are sorority sisters, and that's about it.
I actually thought that I would be the oldest, but a few other ladies got in there before me. But I have the distinct honor of being probably from the farthest away, because I was Junior Miss class of 1973 in Alaska. I met my wonderful husband, Dennis. We ended up here in Niceville, Florida, and we own an awards and engraving shop, and I'm affectionately known as Niceville's trophy wife. This program is so much and more, as is evidenced by these wonderful young ladies that are before you tonight. Not only the competitors, but the girls that have gone on before them. So I too hope that you will consider supporting this program in the future and bring more girls into this program, because it really is our future. Thank you so very much.
Wow, we have a ton of amazing women up here. So like I said earlier, my name is Caitlin Mosley, and I was the 2011 Distinguished Young Woman of Northwest Santa Rosa County, and had the honor of being the 2011 Distinguished Young Woman of Florida at the state program. I was an overall talent and self-expression winner. I went on to nationals and was a top 10 national finalist. Now, I am currently have the honor of being the local chair for the Northwest at-large program for the past 5 years now. And then let's see, I'm also a physician assistant. I got my undergrad at Troy University absolutely free, thanks to Distinguished Young Women. I had zero debt coming out of undergrad. I went to master's at University of South Alabama, and I currently work as a physician assistant in inpatient internal medicine at Sacred Heart Hospital in Pensacola. And then one other fun fact, so if you were here last year, I look a little bit different. I was completely bald last year. So if you want to know how far hair can grow in a year, this is it. I'm a current breast cancer warrior. So. So I will let these wonderful ladies go ahead and exit and take their seats. Because Ted, you know, I would love to give up the mic right now. However, I think myself and a few of these other former state representatives still feel like we have, you know, everything that the girls currently have. We could easily, you know, do this whole thing again, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So we kind of gave the current contestants a little bit of fun, which I don't know how fun this is going to turn out for us, but it'll be highly entertaining for all of you. So I asked the girls earlier this week to write down the most ridiculous onstage questions they have ever heard of or haven't heard of, and write them down and throw them over here in this little bucket. I have no idea what they said or wrote. I'm a little scared, to be completely honest, because these girls have a wild imagination. And I almost made them write their names down on these questions so that I could kind of fuss at them later. So, without further ado, I guess I'm going first. Okay.
Share it with us, Caitlin, share it with us.
Okay, so one of our lovely contestants decided to ask, what part of a burger are you? Okay. I don't want self-expression, I can do this. So, well, ladies and gentlemen, I honestly think that the most important part of a burger, although there is many parts that are very important for all of us, but I think that part is the bun. Because the bun is really what holds us together. Thank you.
Now, I was asked a very critical question in this day and age, and that's, if you could be any type of dog, what would you be? Okay, so I put a lot of thought into this one. And I think if I could be any dog, I would be a Weimaraner, particularly because that is the dog that I have, and it's not because I'm a narcissist, no. It's because my dog and I have photo shoots, and I dress her up in people clothes, and I put my my mom's not gonna like this, but my mom's hair extensions on her. I'm sorry, Mom, I love you. And then we like take pictures, and we have different looks, and I like that.
You know, I wouldn't joke hamburger question because that was actually asked at my state competition. So, good job. Okay, my question is, what is the similarity between a mammal and a coconut? And I assume they mean the hair because that's like the only thing, right? Because we're not filled with like weird milk. So.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, I was given the question regarding the age-old debate of, do you prefer hot air or cold air? And the best answer I can think of is I definitely would prefer hot air, because if I had hot air coming onto me, that must mean that I'm sitting somewhere on a beach, laid out on a towel with
no cares, not even worrying about the mountains of homework I have to do, just watching the dolphins in the horizon. So, hot air for sure. Contestant number 9, Mimi Taylor, thank you.
Oh, it looks like the judges are back, which they're way more important than us because they have some fun results, I'm sure. So thank you very much for entertaining our questions, and thank you, ladies, for these wonderful, insightful questions. We'll be able to put them in the, you know, give them to the judges next year. Thank y'all.
Well done, Caitlin, Valerie, Mimi, and Natalie. Very well done, well done. And welcome again to the Distinguished Young Women Alumni. Look who's here. Al Smith, one of the representatives, in his hand has the documents of some sort. Al, it's very exciting. Very exciting. Thank you very kindly. Whew. But, you know, when they left earlier, I said, I wanted more. Didn't you want to see the group do one more show? Is it just me, or does everyone not want to see the class of 2019 do one more show? Thank you. So during the break, I said, hey, can you just throw something together for us? And they said, and Lauren said, yeah, I think we can do something. So I'm honored to bring back, folks, it is the Florida Class of 2009 Distinguished Young Women. Here they are. Hit it, Bob.
Got you.
Distinguished Young Women Florida Class of 2019. That will be the last bit of entertainment from them. We will have the awards in just a second. So while they're going back and changing, I think it'll be a great time to continue introductions and acknowledging folks who have helped us this week. I want to start off with our State Board of Directors and Committee, and I will ask you to stand if you could be so kind. Erica Wright is somewhere backstage. I still have not seen her, Ken. She's back here somewhere. But Erica Wright, we thank her. Vicki Wilson, Barbara Britt. I saw Barbara out there as one of our State Board of Directors and Committee. Janae Gorham, Deborah Herndon, Deborah Hudson, Beth Manning, Tara Moore, who's a state field director, Kayla Muldoon, Kim Oliver, Natalie Schmidt, Courtney Solly, Kelly Whitfield, who's with the judges right now, Ken Wright, who's over here, there he is, Ken Wright, Betsy Bird, and Carol Bird. So they are the State Board of Directors and Committee. Congratulations there. Now I'd like to introduce the local program chairman. I'll ask them to stand. We have Caitlin Mosley from the Northwest Florida at Large. We saw Caitlin earlier. There she is over there. Did I tell you I love the earrings? They look fabulous, just fabulous. Angela Haar from Washington County. Angela Haar, yes, that is the spirit we're looking for. Julie Stuckey from Walton County. Marion Taylor and Mia Lawson from Okaloosa County. Mia, you're supposed to stand. It says right here, it says, please stand. Right, did you? Thank you, there we go, good, just double check. The other counties were doing it. You could do it here in our county. Mia's a good friend, so. Paige Jones and Pam Oshman from Northwest Florida at Large. Congratulations, Pam. Corey Hillary from Central Florida at Large. Melissa Vasquez from South Florida at Large. Barbara Plummer from Taylor County. So those are our local program chairman. Thank you so much for your assistance. The van drivers. Mike Whitfield is over here. I saw Mike somewhere. Mike Whitfield and Butch Bird. They probably have some very interesting stories. There's Mike over there. I'm not sure where Butch is. So thank you for that. And Suzanne Herzog, our photographer, somewhere out there. So thank you for Suzanne. And it says here, one big helper are my good friend Ryan Price. What have you done as to be called the Distinguished Young Woman mascot, sir? Okay, thank you. So for those from out of town, you're thinking it says Distinguished Young Woman mascot. They thought maybe there'd be some guy with like a head on or something like that. Instead, we have a guy well-dressed, probably wearing some funky socks, some colorful socks. So that is what the criteria is to be the Distinguished Young Woman mascot. So our good friend Ryan Price from Air Force Enlisted Village here today. And you'll be coming up, as a matter of fact, in just a moment, I'm going to be asking the presenters. So if you were asked to be a presenter, I'm going to ask you to get yourself ready, because I'm going to ask you to come up here in just a little bit to present the awards, which are handed to me from Al just a little bit. But before we do that, we want to honor our host families, those people who have opened their homes to our families who have come in. So I'm going to ask you to stand, and then I'm going to ask the host moms to come up on stage, because I have some questions, and I'd like you to do a little skit with me, if you could. Just coming up with it. Just making up as we go. So Gina and Charlie Moss as our host families. Oh, I see we're getting ready for the moms to come up. So Gina and Charlie Moss, thank you for that. Arlene and Sandy DeFries, our host families. Eric and Gabby Carroll. Shane and Nancy Babin. Kevin and Natalie Schmidt. Beth Manning. Terry and Vicki Wilson. Bob and Bonnie Weedman. And Keith and Kim Oliver. Those were our families, the moms. We're going to ask the host family moms to come up here on stage. Not sure if you were expecting this or not, but we're glad that you are playing along with us. So should we ask them some questions about let's ask a couple of you some questions while we have just a moment here. The judges are here, but they want to relax, right? You want to relax and get ready. So we're just going to ask, we'll just ask a couple of the moms. We're going to give you some flowers, and I'm just going to ask a couple of moms some questions, so I'll hand the mic. So we'll just a couple, because we're so honored. We want to thank our host moms for helping out. And I'll start here. How many did you have one family staying with you, or how many girls did you have staying with you?
We have two girls.
Two girls staying with you. And did either of them make their bed each day while they were there?
They both made their beds both days. And it was tough because one of them was sleeping in a Murphy bed.
Oh, there we go. So that was very, very nice of them.
Good.
And what was her favorite breakfast? Did you have a favorite breakfast you served them?
Well, according to Mr. Mike, they kind of ratted me out. The first couple of days, I made homemade biscuits and scrambled eggs for them. But then I was really not so great at the end of the week. And they told me, they said, yeah, she just bought some cinnamon rolls and some Danish and just put them on a plate.
Well, we're grateful for that. We'll just pass the mic down. We'll ask another question. What was the, whoever wants to take the mic next? We'll just take that. If you don't, just pass it down until someone's willing to ask. There we go. It's quicker that way.
It's all right.
So what are the highlights of being a host mom for people who might consider it next year or in their towns? What are some of the highlights of being a host mom?
First of all, you get to spend time. You're right. You can't see anything but these lights. Some time with some of the most fantastic young women the state has to offer. This is our second year to host girls in our home, and I've been working with the program for several years. Since it's only the second year we've had states, the second year I've hosted, and parents, you have raised the most fantastic young women. They are so self-confident. They are. I mean, just outstanding, and they're smart and beautiful and talented, but their confidence is what impresses me the most. Those young women can go anywhere and do anything.
Well done. So, we can't top that. Ladies, host moms, thank you very much for your efforts here. It was fantastic. On behalf of everyone here in Okaloosa County, we appreciate your assistance. So now I'm going to ask the presenters to begin working your way over here. The presenters, come on over here, because I want to have you back here. And thanks again, moms. Thanks again, sponsors. Thanks again, everyone who participated. Certainly, it's been a great show. It's time for them to come back, right? Oh, we're going to do the congressional awards first. All right, then. So now I'm going to ask Senator Don Gates to come up, representing Congressman Gates and Sarah Lefever, his Congressman Gates' assistant, to hand out the Congressional Awards. Matt Gates, Congressional Awards. That's awesome. So that's right. So now, before we do that, of course, we have to bring our Distinguished Young Women back. So here they are, everyone. Put your hands together for our Distinguished Young Women Class of 2019. Ladies, come on out. Right then, so we have, I got to give you a microphone, so I said. So what we have here again, representing you, we heard from President's Senator Don Gates earlier today, and Congressman Matt Gates' assistant, Sarah Lefever, is here. So one of you is going to read the names, and one of you is going to pose for the picture.
Thank you. It's a pleasure to be here today on behalf of the congressman. And the first to receive the congressional recognition is Zoe Schaefer. Next is Michaela Gray. Next, Ivy Berry. Miss Jasmine Coral. Miss Emily Hewitt. Miss Jordana Jernigan. Miss Hilda Trochet. Miss Grace White. Miss Cassie James. Miss Jasmine Sofer. Hannah Grace Smith. Miss Hannah Rogers. Miss Macy Holt. Miss Amber Barnhart. Miss Brookie Brown. And Miss Katie Lightfoot. Congratulations.
Well done, Sarah, on behalf of and Senator Gates, on behalf of Congressman Matt Gates, Congressional Award for each of our attendees today. A really, really cool thing that they will frame and have absolutely for the rest of their life. So that's a great start to our awards ceremony. I think it'd be really fun right now if we could hear from our 2018 Distinguished Young Woman State Champion, the one and only Valerie Trapp. Welcome back, Valerie!
Life-changing. It's a word that I heard tossed around a lot when I first started the Distinguished Young Women of America program. If I'm being completely honest, it's one that I met with equal parts excitement and a little bit of skepticism. How could one program completely change the trajectory of my life? But here I am, 1 year later, and that initial skepticism has completely been refuted. At the local level, I first saw it with smiles. Here at States, I saw it with hospitality. And in Nationals, I saw it with my comfort zones being completely shattered. And as I stand here 1 year later, I know that the impacts of this program extend far further than just the 365 days that I'm the DYW of Florida. So, thank you to Distinguished Young Women for providing me with a sisterhood of women that challenge me and that empower me. Thank you for giving me connections to people who I know are going to be my extended family, from my host family here in Destin to the one in Mobile to Miss Carol and Miss Betsy. And thank you so much for giving me a framework of values of being distinguished that I know I'm going to carry for the rest of my life. So, to the next Distinguished Young Woman of Florida, enjoy this wild, amazing ride. But more than anything, rest assured that when you're standing in my position 1 year from now, your journey with this life-changing program, whose impacts last far throughout your lifetime, they're only going to be beginning. Thank you.
Valerie Trapp, everyone, your Distinguished Young Woman of Florida 2018. Yes, absolutely. Absolutely, she deserves that. Well done, Valerie. Well done. All righty. Well, folks, well done, Valerie. It is now time. I am honored. As you saw earlier, Al was kind enough to bring up the awards, and I will bring out a presenter, announce the presenter, and then announce the awards. I'd like to start off with the Be Yourself, Be Your Best Self Award, presented by Natalie Lawson. You've seen Natalie. She is the Distinguished Young Woman of Florida 2014 and a national top 10 presenter. Natalie, you look fabulous. Are you ready to present the Be Your Best Self Award? You are. She has the envelopes in her hand. In this case, we have an honoree. The honoree for the Be Your Best Self Award is Hannah Rogers. Hannah gets it's $250. $250. Well done, Hannah. Well, she just bolted out there, didn't she, to get that? And now, the winner for the Be Your Best Self Award for $500, Macy Holt. Well done, Natalie. Congratulations. Good pause there. Presenters, make sure you hug them long enough for people to take their picture, will you? They come out, they dash out. Next up, presenting the Arden Robertson Spirit Award is our one and only Ryan Price from Air Force Enlisted Village and the Distinguished Young Woman Florida mascot that I introduced earlier. He is a fun, fun guy, and we're honored to have him associated with the group here. And that's all you need. It's all you need. When you go back to your various cities and counties around the state for next year, you say, you mean I can be your mascot if I just wear goofy socks? The answer is yes. So carry that message back here to Okaloosa County. We have now the Arden Robertson Spirit Award, and the winner is Katie Lightfoot for $500. Congratulations, Katie, and thank you, Ryan Price and Air Force Enlisted Village, for helping out there. Well done, sir. The Fitness Award, presented by one of our sponsors, Denise Kendas from Fort Walton Beach Medical Center. Denise, thank you very much. Great to see you. Right up there in the front of the stage, we have, in this case, folks, two honorees and a winner, so I will advise that the first honoree for $250 is Hannah Rogers. Congratulations, Hannah. Honoree number one. And oh, there's our photographer right there. Oh, you stay out there. You got two more to go. That's right. So Denise is wonderful. She's the marketing director for Omish Medical Center. She's absolutely delightful. We're happy to have them as a sponsor. The second honoree for $250 for the fitness award is Amber Barnhart. And as presented by Denise Kendust and the Fort Omish Medical Center, the winner of the 2019 Fitness Award would be $500, Katie Lightfoot. All right then, thank you Denise, and thank you winners there. Well done, thank you Denise, and thanks for your sponsorship. Speaking of sponsorship, coming up next, for the Self-Expression Award is Jerry Williams, the president of Eglin Federal Credit Union, which is an outstanding facility here in town. He also has Mark Franks with him, Sherry Harlow, and maybe others from Eglin Federal Credit Union, a great supporter of all good things in our community. So Jerry, are you ready? You are ready. We in this case have two honorees for the Self-Expression Award. The first honoree for $250, Katie Lightfoot. Congratulations, congratulations, Katie. Jerry, as you know, we have another honoree for $250, and that is Brookie Brown. And to be presented here, Self-Expression by Jerry Williams from Eglin Federal Credit Union, the winner of the Self-Expression Award for $500, Cassandra James. Right then. Thank you, Jerry. Congratulations to the Self-Expression Award winners. And now for the Tara Moore Talent Award, our friend Mimi Taylor, Distinguished Young Woman of Florida 2016, will once again take the stage. Mimi, it's exciting, isn't it? Whoa, it is that. The Tara Moore Talent Award. And in this case, there are also two honorees. So the first honoree for the Tara Moore Talent Award would be Hannah Grace Smith for $250. The second honoree for the Tara Moore Talent Award would be Brookie Brown. And the winner, which will soon be presented by Mimi Taylor, Distinguished Young Woman of Florida 2016, of the Tara Moore Talent Award for $500, Hilda Trochet! All right, Mimi, thank you very kindly for that. I am honored to bring out another one of our sponsors, Heather Rees, who's the Senior Marketing Director and Leasing Representative at Destin Commons, and our favorite ever Pledge of Allegiance representative, Olivia, to give us the award. Thank you, Heather, and thank you, Olivia, for that. Today is the Scholastic Award. The Scholastic Award, Heather and Olivia, and there are two honorees. And the first honoree for $250 is Michaela Gray. Michaela Gray. There we go. And the second honoree for the Scholastic Award is Jordana Jernigan. There we go. And again, presented by Heather and Olivia, the Scholastic Award. The winner for $500 is Cassie James. Cassie James, Scholastic Award winner. All right then, congratulations and thanks again to Destin Commons for their support of the Distinguished Young Women State Finals here in Fort Walton Beach, Florida. I am now honored to bring out Nick Zimmerman and his delightful daughter, Genesis, who will present the J. Odom Group Interview Award. Jay Odom, the title sponsor of today's event, Genesis, was on the stage earlier dancing. She has had, Nick, she's had a great time, has she? No doubt. You look fabulous. You look delightful. So we're going to have you move, Nick, a little bit towards the center so everyone can see Genesis there as she presents the award for the Jay Odom Group interview. Nice job with the lights there, gentlemen. Well done. And we have two honorees for the Jay Odom Group Interview Award. And the first one, do we need the first honoree for the Jay Odom Interview Award is Brookie Brown. Brookie Brown honoree. Well done there. Thank you very much. Congratulating Brookie. The second honoree, Nick and Genesis, is Jordana Jernigan. Congratulations. No doubt we will see Genesis on the stage in about 14 years, I suppose it would be. So mark your notes now. Nick, are you ready? Are Nick and Genesis ready to give the winner of the Jay Odom Group Interview Award by the Jay Odom Group and the winner for $500, Cassandra James? Congratulations, Nick and Genesis, for issuing the Jay Odom Awards. Please thank Jay and the Jay Odom Group for their support of this great cause. There we go. Congratulations. Thank you, Nick and Genesis. Folks, I am back to my last sheet. I only have three awards left. We have a second alternate, first alternate, and then the winner. But before that, Genesis would like to do her own routine of talent, sex, self-expression, and talent and fitness. Here we go. She has caught the limelight, everyone. Distinguished young woman, class of 2028 or 29, whatever it may be. But congratulations, thank you there. That's kind of the way Valerie feels today, too, after she's leaving the stage for the last time. And no doubt, this is how our friend Natalie Lawson, who's going to represent how she felt when she had to turn over her seat. Natalie Lawson, Distinguished Young Woman, Florida 2014, and the National Finals. Will you please come out to the front and be prepared to give our second alternate, which is a $1,000 presentation. $1,000. The second alternate, as presented by Natalie Lawson, Hannah Grace Smith. Thank you, Natalie. Congratulations, Hannah Grace Smith, second alternate. Caitlin Mosley, will you please come back on stage and have everyone who did not see your cool earrings earlier have a chance to see them again. As you recall, Caitlin was a 2011 Florida Distinguished Young Woman and National Finalist, and she's been helping out all week as she has done actually for the last couple of years, and we are honored now. Caitlin, it's $2,000 that you'll be presenting. $2,000 for the first alternate. And the winner is of the first alternate is Cassandra James. Cassandra James. Congratulations, Cassandra. There we have it, folks. And before I announce this, I want to again thank our judges, Donna French, Dr. Rick French, Wendy Lipham, Michael Moser, and Pam Moser for coming out and visiting with us here in Fort Walton Beach. I want to thank all of our sponsors who came here today and all of our guests from around the state of Florida. We were honored to have you here in Fort Walton Beach, and we enjoy hosting this event very, very much. I want to remind everyone that we have the event at the island after this event. I am now pleased, Valerie Trapp, will you please come out? Valerie Trapp, our National Finalist and Distinguished Young Woman of Florida for 2018. She has the honor of representing the state of Florida, and now this is a $10,000 value. Your Distinguished Young Woman of Florida 2019 is Katie Lightfoot! east on Highway 98. Thank you all for coming. Thanks for visiting Fort Walton.